The secret to quitting smoking, what nobody will ever tell you. Ever wonder why it's so hard for you to quit smoking? Want to know what most people and why most people like you fail at quitting smoking? Did you know that there is something about why we get stuck that almost nobody knows? It's why I call it the secret to quitting smoking. If everyone knew it, everyone would just quit. And it wouldn't be a secret, now would it? I'm also going to explain to you so that you understand what that one thing is. And I'm going to give you 4 tips that you can actually do to stay quit. So make sure you stay to the end of the video to get those 4 tips. If this is your first time to my channel, make sure you subscribe, especially if you're interested in tips, tricks, and hacks on how to quit smoking. I'm also going to put a link in the description below, so that you can book yourself into a free 15-minute phone consultation with me. It's free and it's easy. Just go ahead, hit the link and book yourself in. If these techniques work for you, then please comment in the comment section below. If you just have questions, put them in the comment section below. That's the whole point of the comment section. So please go ahead and use it. We answer every question. So let's hop right into the content. What's the secret to quitting smoking? The answer is congruency. So just before I hop into exactly what that means and get into the actual neuroscience behind it, I just want to tell you a story. When I tried to quit, and I tried, I must have been 50 times, but I can remember one thing that was almost universal in all the times I tried to quit and I struggled and I failed. I can remember thinking to myself in my conscious thoughts, I don't want to smoke. I don't want to smoke. I'm not going to smoke. I'm going to quit. I don't want to smoke. And I would get up and I'd be determined that this is the day. I'm never going to smoke another cigarette for the rest of my life. And I was so determined. And the day would go on. And sometimes I might make it to day 2. But my conscious mind is going, I don't want to smoke. I don't want to smoke. I don't want to smoke. But something in the back of my brain, in my unconscious mind, kept saying, what are you, crazy? Smoke, feel good. I enjoy smoking. It's an enjoyable compulsion for me. It was like my mind was going in 2 different directions. My conscious thoughts kept saying, I don't want to smoke, I don't want to smoke, I don't want to smoke. But for some reason, I just kept failing. That's what it was like for me. Does that sound familiar? That is what we call in neuroscience being psychologically incongruent. Part of our mind is going one direction and the other part is going another direction. So to understand this incongruency and why becoming congruent is really the secret to quitting smoking, we have to go on a little bit of a journey as to how our brain actually works. The actual neuroscience behind our conscious and our unconscious thoughts. So here's the really basics and all you really need to understand in order to understand 4 things that you can do to kind of hack the system, your system or anybody's system. So you have one mind. Even though we talk about a conscious mind, unconscious mind, you don't have 2 different minds. You have one mind. You have conscious thoughts and unconscious thoughts, and they do a dance. And we know a lot about this in neuroscience. We know a lot about your conscious thoughts, and we actually know a lot about your unconscious thoughts, and we know how they work. And there are 2 golden rules when it comes to smoking about our conscious thoughts and our unconscious thoughts that are really important. Rule number 1 is what your conscious mind does, what your conscious thoughts do, your thinking thing, the internal dialogue, what it does, your unconscious mind is not capable of. It can't do them. Your mind is what is called bifurcated. It's separated on purpose so that your conscious thoughts can become highly specialized and very good at certain things, and your unconscious mind can become highly specialized and very good at certain things. This is what it means to be bifurcated. It's an evolutionary advantage we have over other species. So what our conscious mind does, our unconscious mind can't do, and vice versa. What our conscious mind does, our conscious mind can't do. That's golden rule number 1. Golden rule number 2 is your conscious mind, it's not very powerful. It can only do 5 to 7 things at any given moment. That's it. Your unconscious mind is a supercomputer. It can do trillions of simultaneous computations at one time. It is so powerful that even today we cannot build a supercomputer, not even a quantum computer, that can rival the power of your unconscious mind. So those are the two rules. What one does, the other cannot do. So what your conscious mind does, your unconscious mind can't do. Your conscious mind is very much a wimp compared to your super powerful unconscious mind. So if we keep those two rules in mind, we can now look at the relationship between our conscious mind going, I don't want to smoke, I don't want to smoke, I don't want to smoke, and this unconscious desire, what comes from our unconscious mind that causes us to fail time and time again. This is what's called being psychologically incongruent. It just means your conscious mind's going one way and your unconscious mind's going the other. That's all it means. And the secret to quitting smoking is learning how to become psychologically congruent. Because if you can take your unconscious mind and line it up with your conscious desire to quit, guess what? Quitting becomes so much easier. And one thing you need to know before I start to get into the four things that you can actually do on your own, here's what you need to know. This knowledge that I'm sharing with you is not likely to get you to quit. 93% of people need the aid of a paid program to actually quit for life. So the information I'm going to give you, it will be helpful and it will put you on the right journey and it will help give you the tools that you need to be successful. Because if your idea of being successful at quitting smoking is, I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and I'm going to quit cold turkey, okay, that's not a plan. If you fail to plan to quit smoking, you are planning for failure. So that's what we're really giving you when we give you these four things about things you can actually do to become more congruent. But just remember, it's not a replacement for a comprehensive quit smoking program, which will give you all of these tools and many, many more. So let's hop right into tip number one, becoming conscious of your incongruency. It sounds somewhat simplistic, but becoming aware forces your mind to grapple with the issue. This is why when you just get up one morning and say, I'm not going to smoke, you haven't given your mind any time to prepare or plan. You need to prepare, okay? Otherwise, we're just kind of fumbling in the dark. So we need to start to become conscious of our incongruency. Become aware of it. Notice how you're thinking to yourself, I don't want to smoke. And then notice this uncontrollable urge you have. Start to notice and become aware of the internal conflict. Shine a flashlight in that dark corner of your mind where you don't look that often. So becoming aware, that's tip number one. Become aware of the incongruency and actually make a point to focus on it. Tip number two, do a program that helps you to change your unconscious mind. Here is why. Because your conscious mind is already going in the direction you want it to. This is why things like the books, the apps, the cold turkey, all these things have the lowest success rate because your conscious mind's already on board. So only 7% of people quit using those methods. The problem is your unconscious mind is not, it's going in another direction. That's why so many people fail when they think all they have to do is deal with it from a conscious mind point of view. So tip number two is find a program that deals with this part, deals with the unconscious mind. So that could be things like hypnosis, like NLP, like EFT. There's tons of them. Do some research and find programs that deal with your unconscious mind because that is the part that you have to turn the line in the right direction. And don't be worried about seeking professional help. Seeking out help is only going to benefit you. Tip number three, learn to deal with cravings. Why? Well, because cravings are real. And cravings are also a factor of your unconscious mind. Here is why. Withdrawal is physical. Withdrawal is a physical symptom. A craving is a psychological system that is derived from your unconscious thoughts. This is why tip number two is all about finding a program that deals with your unconscious mind. Tip number three is deal with the cravings in your unconscious mind, which in other words, learn to plan for the cravings. That in of itself is going to get you over a huge hump because almost everybody will tell you, if I just didn't have the cravings, I could quit like that. So you need to plan for them. Plan for the cravings. Learn about cravings and how to deal with them. Any quit smoking program that you do needs to have this as a central point of the program. So tip number four, learn to do stacking. This is basically about putting those first three tips all together. And I'll post a link in the video right up here to the left about what stacking is, so you can learn about the stacking method. Simply put, I'll explain it to you very simply. You'll get more detail in that video. Stacking is merely approaching the problem as if you were a whole person. The reason why quit smoking methods typically only deal with one aspect of the problem, that's what most quit smoking programs do. They only deal with one aspect of the problem. For example, reading Alan Carr's book, it only deals with your conscious thoughts. Nicotine replacement therapies, like the gum, the patch, the chew, the drugs, the Zyban, the Chantix, they only deal with the problem as if it's an addiction. Hypnosis or hypnotherapy only deals with it as if it's your unconscious mind. Now, granted, it's mostly your unconscious mind. That's why those models have the most success rate. But what stacking is stacking all of these together into a single method. So let's summarize here. First thing you need to do is accept that you'll need to become psychologically congruent. That's the first thing you need to do. And start to pay attention to it. Two, it's okay to go for outside help or do a paid program. That's what 93% of people that successfully quit smoking actually do. Three, look for methods that deal with your unconscious mind. Learn how to deal with cravings and plan, because failure to plan is planning to fail. Five, learn how to do stacking. If you do all of that, you will immediately increase your chances of success tenfold over just doing cold turkey. Now, if this video was helpful to you or this is your first time to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and make sure you hit the notification button. And don't forget, I'm going to put a link in the description below so that you can book yourself into a free 15-minute phone consultation with me. Take advantage of it. It's free. And I also want to know if you think something else was the secret for you to quit smoking. Put it in the comment section. Or if you have questions, put those in the comment section below as well. And also, you can get more information by going to my website. I have ebooks that you can download about how to prepare your mind for quitting smoking. Go to my Facebook group or go to my Instagram channel. There is tons of free information. There are tons of tips, tricks, and hacks on how to quit smoking. I want to thank you very much for your time. Blessings to everyone. And I'll talk to you soon.